थैंक यू।
थैंक यू अशोक भाई, थैंक्स फॉर योर एनकरेजिंग वर्ड्स। आई वुड नाउ लाइक टू इनवाइट महेश जी नार, चीफ सेक्रेटरी ऑफ बैंगलोर चैप्टर, टू प्लीज गिव अस द वर्ड्स ऑफ।
जय जिनेंद्र टू ऑल द मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट हियर, गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल। लगभग 8 महीने पहले जब ये पर्टिकुलर टीम काम शुरू की थी, जीटो बैंगलोर मैनेजिंग कमिटी, सो द फोकस वॉज on business, the focus was on networking, and the focus was on leadership creation. So I think we did a lot of activities related to that, and as we went along, COVID, the second wave started, and last 3-4 months we had to be satisfied with doing the social work towards the COVID activities. But abhi wapas thoda sa COVID ka concern thoda sa kam pada hai, इसके लिए हम वापस एक्टिविटी शुरू करने के लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं ऑन बिजनेस फ्रंट, ऑन नेटवर्किंग फ्रंट एंड ऑन द लीडरशिप बिल्डिंग फ्रंट। इसी माध्यम में ये पर्टिकुलर सेमिनार वेबिनार के द्वारा रखा गया है। वी ऑलवेज फोकस्ड ऑन कीपिंग अ फिजिकल मीट एट जीटो ऑफिस और एनी अदर प्लेस, बट वी फेल्ट टू गेट द राइट interest in this particular offline to online concept, we can probably start with the webinar, and once the people show interest, we can handhold those particular members and do a physical meeting with them so that the inputs might be much better. I also recognize the presence of Mahavir Bhai Mehta, our FX director, amongst us. So as we are moving forward, there are some programs lined up in the next couple of months because September mein lagbhag last week mein AGM hogi. So currently we have July to September, October and August, and August to September. We have about 2 months. In these 2 months, we are going to have a program on labor reforms, the new labor reforms that are going to get activated from October 1st. Then we are going to have a very important physical program that is called BizPro, a business related program where 50 plus opportunities will be given to people pan Bangalore that covers your dealership, distributorship, franchising, investment opportunities. So this is being done on August 26th and 27th. And at Sheraton Grand Yeshwanpur. So requesting all the members to please be in tune with us so that as and when we promote this particular activity, definitely this will be a very promising and very happening program covering different investment opportunities and business opportunities where companies like Samsung and other companies will probably come and give their opportunities of investment. Post that, we also are looking at a girls hostel inaugural in the near future, probably August end, if the pandemic settles down much further. And post that, we are going to have few more programs like a particular forum for textile that we call Jito Business Forum. Many programs are lined up, business programs specifically in next 2 months, and requesting all the members to please make sure that you utilize this opportunity. And on a very promising note, little different from business, we have also started the construction work on the second Vihar Dham for apne sadhu sadhviyo ke liye. सेकेंड विहार धाम का कंस्ट्रक्शन आज शुरू किया है। दिस इज 15 किलोमीटर्स फ्रॉम टुमकुर, अवे फ्रॉम टुमकुर। सो दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव स्टार्टेड। सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज दैट जीटो बैंगलोर इज बीइंग डूइंग एंड प्रोबेबली विल डू इन द फ्यूचर। सो वेलकमिंग यू ऑल अगेन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर वेबिनार। हितेश भाई, ऑल ओवर टू यू।
थैंक यू महेश भाई, थैंक्स फॉर अपडेटिंग अस विद ऑल द जीटो एक्टिविटीज। Now I would like to invite Shripalji Bachawat, C Square Solutions. His company, he's a champion of e-commerce, and his company was recently acquired by Reliance Jio. And ये टाइम में व्हाई गोइंग ऑनलाइन इज इम्पोर्टेंट, ही विल थ्रो सम लाइट ऑन इट. सो श्रीपाल जी प्लीज गिव योर वर्ड्स ऑफ विजडम सर.
Hey Jinendra, everyone. I have very simple analogy to this. हम पहले एक जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल हम लोग राजस्थान जाते थे तो हमारे पास एक हफ्ते में एक ट्रेन हुआ करती थी और वो भी मतलब डायरेक्ट नहीं, यहाँ से आप चेन्नई जाओ या बॉम्बे जाओ फिर वहां से दूसरी ट्रेन पकड़ो एंड दिस वॉज अवर पास्ट डेज. देन धीरे धीरे ऑप्शंस बढ़े, डायरेक्ट ट्रेन आने लगी, एक नहीं दो ट्रेन आने लगी, रोज की ट्रेन हो गई, फिर एसी आ गया उसके अंदर, एक तरफ से बसेस आ गई, लॉन्ग टर्म लॉन्ग जर्नी बसेस आ गए, एयरलाइंस आ गई. सो टुडे टू रीच टू राजस्थान आई हैव मल्टीपल वेज टू रीच आउट. सो एज अ कस्टमर और एज अ ट्रैवलर आई हैव नाउ ऑप्शन टू ट्रैवल मल्टीपल वेज एंड दिस इज वॉट हैपेंड इन अक्रॉस द इंडस्ट्री. And this is what my belief is that ki now we need to really leverage our business. Humne itna kaam kiya hai, so why not leverage the benefit of that? And that is where I believe that e-commerce is a very, very important platform. Now, we have heard only e-commerce. But the fact is that ki almost every alphabet has a commerce now. So whether it is T-commerce, whether it is P-commerce, which is physical commerce, whether it is M-commerce, whether it is S-commerce, which we call it as social commerce, or M-commerce is mobile commerce, whether C-commerce, which is community commerce, or whether it is new commerce, which is basically working with big people at a hyperlocal level, then comes omni-commerce, live commerce, which is again China is revolutionizing that, and the print commerce. If you would have seen now, print commerce also has changed a little bit. Now, for example, last week paper, if you see, all the real estate people would have put advertisement together. So it's basically the earlier it used to be one guy putting advertisement. Now everyone put together to change the way people behave. In fact, if you see, automobiles are now selling on online. No more showrooms. Either Chetak.com or OlaElectric.com or Ether scooters, everything. So business have moved from a very traditional commerce to a e-commerce world. Now, why should I be doing that? Is the question, big question. My business is anyway flourishing. We will not even come to know when customer wants multiple channels. I am not saying what we are doing is right or wrong. We are doing fantastically well. We have in this shop, the traditional businesses were running from decades or even centuries or half centuries. But then time has come where we have become now multi-channel, not just restrict ourselves to a one medium of selling to reaching out to customer. Give the option to the customer. Why not you only become everyone? So to begin with, I believe that you should start with simple commerce like social commerce or even WhatsApp commerce, which we call it as community commerce. I think these are all some of the things. And Hiteshji, you are doing fantastic. This Jito's initiative is really appreciable. When I heard first time last week, I was really excited that this is something required for our entrepreneurs because we are known for businesses. As a businessman, we are known as a community. But then are we being left behind? तो ये एक कॉमर्स का जो पार्ट है, आई थिंक इट्स अ ग्रेट इनिशिएटिव. आई सिंसियरली रिकमेंड दैट एवरीवन टू स्केल अप. नाउ अर्लियर 10% ग्रोथ वाज ओके. इफ यू नोटिस इन द लास्ट 3-4 इयर्स ऑल द कॉमर्स एसोसिएटेड कंपनीज, दैट इज ऑल दिस एडिशनल कॉमर्स कंपनीज हैव ग्रोन बियॉन्ड 4x. दिस इज वॉट वी विल look into it now. Hiteshji, I think if you can throw light on those areas and make our members and all our fellow brothers and sisters to avail this e-commerce journey. And that's my wish. Wishing you all the best to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Shripalji. Thank you so much for your talk on e-commerce and what's the importance of this. Now, without further ado, I straight away would like to jump to the presentation and presentation, initial few slides, I'm going to talk about what the platform is about, all about what all it can do, and then we'll have an interactive live demo demonstration also. We have Manish Agarwal, the founder of SnapPay with us, in fact, who is giving us the complete platform. Manish has been instrumental with us when we started JVN journey back in January with creating a JVN bot and automating the whole JVN operations. We will be discussing about this e-commerce module to be launched from last 3-4 months. Unfortunately, due to COVID, we could not launch earlier. So let me just share my screen and so now challenges faced by small business. Now, especially after COVID, we have all noticed that काफी चैलेंजेस आ रही है बिजनेस में. लिमिटेड कस्टमर रीच है, कस्टमर्स शॉप में आ नहीं रहे हैं. बिजनेसेस हु आर सेलिंग ऑन लार्ज ई कॉमर्स वेबसाइट सच एज फ्लिपकार्ट, अमेजोन एक्सेट्रा, वहां पे अपनी कोई ब्रांड आइडेंटिटी नहीं रहती है. ऑल्सो दीज पीपल दे चार्ज हैवी मार्जिन फ्रॉम अस, सो अपनी मार्जिन की चैलेंजेस रहती है. दे आर हार्डली एनी इजी टू ऑपरेट डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म्स विच विल ट्रांसफॉर्म और रिड्यूस द टाइम ऑफ द ओनर्स. Merchants do not have a proper channel to increase awareness about their business among their community. Now, how do we come out of these problems or challenges? Unified e-commerce enablement platform that empowers all small medium businesses by easily setting up their online store and helping them grow their business by building their brand identity and establishing a customer base. Now, so there are three points: digitize transactions and streamline processes, boost sales and marketing, provide insights and support management through exceptions. जैसे digitizing में हो गया ordering लेना, accounting वगैरह details है, या catalogs वगैरह WhatsApp पे share करना, CRM basic CRM जो task management होता है या lead management है, जनरेटिंग एनालिटिक्स बेसिक बिजनेस एनालिटिक्स के क्या बिजनेस क्या प्रोडक्ट चल रहा है, क्या कैटेगरी चल रही है, कौन कस्टमर बिजनेस दे रहा है, कितना बिजनेस दे रहा है. एक बेसिक एनालिटिक्स हमारे बिजनेस में काफी लोग नहीं करते हैं, विच इज द नीड ऑफ द आवर. नाउ सोल्यूशन व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू प्रोवाइड विद दिस प्लेटफॉर्म इज वी हैव अ बिजनेस, वी आर ऑलवेज ऑन द मोबाइल, वी आर ऑलवेज ऑन द व्हाट्सएप. हाउ कैन वी लिंक दिस मोबाइल एंड व्हाट्सएप थ्रू एन ई कॉमर्स शॉप and the B2B B2C customers who can come to our WhatsApp or to our website and place orders. How can we increase our business through affiliates? Affiliates are basically more like resellers jo apna product bechte hain on through social commerce or WhatsApp se forward karke, and they get their commission out of it. Usko hum kaise leverage kar sakte hain, uspe we have built some modules around that. Distribution chain, this also works. This platform is ideal for B2B business also, jahan pe dealers, distributors, retailers, sabke liye kaam aa sakta hai. Supply chain, how can we integrate supply chains like Shiprocket, etc. So, jo order aaye apan unko kaise online Shiprocket ke through bech sake. Sales and delivery, backend ka jo bhi automation hai, simple tarike se WhatsApp pe kar sakenge. Banking related, accounting related information jo customers mangta hai, apne ko khud ko chahiye. All that can be done through WhatsApp. Now we have a lot of these tools like Shopify, Tally, etc., which can be easily integrated with this particular solution and makes our life much easier to manage multiple things on WhatsApp and a simple dashboard. Now coming to the platform features, sales and marketing mein we have a lot of features. I'll not go one by one, but some key features like distribution channel management hai, different price list for dealers hai, catalog वगैरह instantly भिजवाना है, quotations भिजवाने हैं, operations and accounting, tally को integrate करना है. This solution can integrate tally very well. Inventory वगैरह we can get on click of a button on WhatsApp. Lead management, task management, as I mentioned earlier. Chatbot है जो basic queries काफी time क्या होता है, काफी customers simple क्वेरीज के लिए अपने को कॉल करते हैं, विच ऑल कैन बी डन थ्रू ऑटोमेशन यूजिंग चैटबॉट. सपोर्ट एंड सीआरएम, अगेन अगर कोई इशू है कस्टमर का, कोई प्रॉब्लम है, ऑल ही कैन डू इज जस्ट सेंड अ व्हाट्सएप मैसेज एंड आपका सिस्टमेटिक तरीके से टिकट क्रिएट हो जाएगा जो इजीली आप सर्विस दे पाएंगे. and hence increase the customer satisfaction also. Delivery and logistics, this platform is integrated with ShipRocket, and there's a delivery app also. If somebody is into a hyperlocal business, jo din ki 100, 150, 200 deliveries hoti hai, unke liye we have a delivery app also, which can make their delivery operation seamless. Now, how will customers find Jito merchants? Hum log cha rahe hain ke we have a jitobangalore.com website jahan pe sare members ka database rahega. Anybody can search any category or any member and get their data and directly go to their particular website or WhatsApp and do the transactions. We have a bot, we have a exclusive JBN, Jito JBN bot, jahan se bot se aap inquiry kar sakte hain, jaise looking for a car care product example, jo hum abhi aage dikhayenge. So, jo bhi apne Jito members hain, unka catalog yahan pe aa jayega, they can directly communicate from here. And we will also give a microsite for every single member who is registering here. We can also give a complete website, but basic level mein we can give a microsite. Now let's go to live demo. Before we go to live demo, ek number diya hua maine ye 7217630169. You can save this number and just send one WhatsApp message hashtag register my business. That's it, and it will ask you some simple steps. You can register on WhatsApp itself, and I will now hand over to Manish, who is going to run through the demonstration of every single activity what we are trying to achieve. Manish, over to you.
Thank you, Hitesh bhai. Jai Jinend, everyone. I know I had earlier interacted with some of you through a few webinars we had done, as well as, of course, the JBN members would hopefully be using and enjoying the JBN bot that we had created. So Hitesh bhai and Shripal ji, they shared the concept around the need to digitize and the attempt that we are trying to do at SnapPay and work with Jito Bangalore specifically is to use WhatsApp as the heart of your digitization exercise. So as Hitesh bhai said, there are various different dimensions or angles of a business. E-commerce is definitely one of that, but there are a lot of other things. You have a distribution chain. You would like to enable the distribution chain via the platform. Similarly, a lot of your operational tasks as well, you would like to digitize so that you can focus more on the business development side and less on managing the operations, which are often mundane. So what we'll do is that please go ahead and it's a simple bot that is available on that number, which is the same JBN bot, where you can register. And as you would see, it's a very, very simple process of registering your business and getting your own website created. What I will do further is talk about various different angles on how a B2B, a B2C, as well as a direct to consumer operations can be digitized and e-commerce done using the platform that we are building specifically for Jito Bangalore. So to begin with, what we have done is that we have created a website called Jito Bangalore. Let me just open this. This is the website that you see. Around January timeframe, we had taken the liberty and created certain businesses of JBN members within this platform. And this is like a private, you know, just dial for Jito Bangalore. So a complete directory listing of your businesses, they get listed out here. So people can search specifically for a particular product or a service and get the details of that if there is an online store available for that, they can also go ahead and click that and get the details of that. So for example, a couple of businesses, let's say I'm searching for solar panels, and so one of the JBN members runs this company, Suntrop Solar. I'm not sure if he's there in the session today. So we've created a web store for them. It's a sample web store. People can straight away go here and log in and start placing order. So it becomes a discovery platform plus an online ordering system for the entire Jito members of Bangalore who are on the platform as such. And once you register yourself, you automatically get listed out here. A few others that we have created. So for example, we have Hitesh Bhai's company. Let's say if I'm searching for car care, I would get all the businesses that are categorized as automotive or car care companies. And for Hitesh Bhai, we have also created a web store for his 3M and other car care products, which we'll soon walk through and see how that order placing and other experience happens. So we've also enabled both B2B and B2C features for Hitesh Bhai, and we'll shortly talk about that. Another business that we are right now working is with Rahul Bhai, who runs Paras Creations. So, for example, if someone is searching for saris, they get all the business listed out here. Also, what we've done for Rahul Bhai is that we've also enabled a dedicated WhatsApp channel for him. So, if someone goes ahead and says hi to that, automatically the chatbot is able to start taking order for Rahul, for Paras Creation. In fact, if we take this forward, what we've done is, so just to give you a background, Paras Creation has most of their business in Maharashtra, and they operate through wholesalers and semi-wholesalers. And a lot of time these, distribution chain members are not as technology savvy. So what we've done for them is that we've enabled write the catalog capturing, and because it's a sari business, it's critical to to be able to see those pictures. So for example, let's say I'm selecting the first item itself. They want to take a look at the brocade items. So Rahul Bhai has a backend panel through which he can manage his catalog. Also, what we've done for him is that you can define the role of a person. So I've registered as a wholesaler. So the pricing that I'm seeing is actually that Rahul Bhai has set up for me. Also, this is one part of it wherein they can go ahead and check the items that are available as of now. They can also place an order right from the bot itself. So that's where we have used some of the image recognition capabilities wherein they don't need to go to an app or go to a website and then search for those items and place an order. All they need to do is forward those specific images, one or multiple of them, and just say, okay, they're done with that. And so as you can see here, we are just confirming the order details and by sending the image back. And once as a customer, I say yes, the order kind of gets placed. And a final confirmation on quantity and other remarks or specific colors that they want to take or not take, all of that they can provide by clicking on that link, which is a pre-authenticated link. So they can change the quantity, put certain comments if they want specific colors or don't want specific colors, and then go ahead and then place an order right here itself. And so Rahul Bhai wants to first validate that the item is available. Only then he wants to confirm. So we've sent a message that your order has been received. We will confirm it back to you. So this is one angle of how the entire e-commerce has been directed to WhatsApp. Now, I'll take another example, which is of Plus 91. There again, the discovery could either happen via this channel, or there is another way where at the same bot, what we could do is that I could search, like I said, I could search for car care. So here again, all the relevant businesses. So in fact, I'll use a different number in order to showcase this. Just give me a second.
Till the time Manish sets up the thing, anybody has any question, the chat box is open. You can please put your queries or questions on the chat box and we'll try to address all of those.
Right. So I'm using a different number because the other one is already registered. So here I can go ahead and search for car care items. And okay. This is right now. I'm in a different mode. But basically, I can search for those items and go ahead and place an order. What I'll do is that I will go. So what we've done specifically for Hitesh Bhai again is that we have created a specific WhatsApp channel for him. This is the Plus 91 channel. And I can go ahead and send a hi and be able to get the, right now I'm in a merchant support mode. I'll go back and we'll be able to place an order right over here. And here again, as you would see, that we can see the prices that are relevant for me. I am registered for Hitesh Bhai as a distributor. So I get those prices and I can go ahead and place an order. So actually, let's go ahead and place an order here. This is my cart. I'm selecting, let's say, this location. We've also integrated with ShipRocket. So if required, we can get the delivery schedule and the charges right there from ShipRocket. And simply I just go ahead and place the order. And I will come here and get a confirmation of the order that gets placed. So essentially, a lot of these operations, if you see, are happening right there on WhatsApp and via the Jito JBN channel or via the dedicated channels that we create for you. Now, moving forward, that was the ordering part of it. There are a lot of other angles that we have created. Which is again a very interesting one that we've created for a company called Dust Minute, and you might be find that interesting as well. And that is, so Dust Minute is into grocery supplies at, at different gated societies. So what we've done is that we've enabled them to create orders right on the chatbot itself. So like you would typically create a, you know, a grocery list. Let's say I want whole wheat bread. And so our background processes will run through, understand what product the user wants to add. If they want to, for example, not very clear, and then they say they want toned milk, for example. Right. We will give specific choices for them to select from in case they are there, and keep on adding items to the cart. And finally, the customers, they can go ahead and check it out, check out those items here, and go ahead and place the order. And then in case they want to add certain more items here, they can add more items. And they wanted, let's say, a pichku tomato ketchup, right? Or any of those items, they can change the quantity and stuff and go ahead and place an order. So I've explained three different mechanisms through a discovery mechanism via the website, like we saw in case of Plus91, then via sending images through the bot itself, as well as through a conversational mechanism through which people can create their cart and directly check it out via that route itself. Now, taking it forward, I think one of the very important aspects of a business is the customer relationship management and being able to send promotional messages to your business contacts via WhatsApp becomes quite important. So in order to enable that, again, what we've done is that we've made it all available via WhatsApp itself. So what I can do is I will send promotion messages, for example. Right, and then it need not be specifically that. We understand the intent of what you as a business is trying to do. You select, the customer list. So you can go ahead and then create your targeted customer list for sending your promotions. And once you decide that, all you need to do is send your images. I'll just send this image. Right. I say done. So I can send one or multiple images. So basically what this thing is trying to do is that if, let's say, you have 500 customers that you want to send a message across, you just compose it once. Test message for Jito demo. For example, I put it this way. And the bot will, once confirm this is the message that you want to send, and once you confirm that, the bot goes about and pushes those messages across to as many number that are there in that customer list. And of course, there is a comprehensive and intelligent backend panel that is available through which you can manage your customer lists effectively. So we'll be shortly.
Just to add to this, we can also create a different customer list. Just a dealer ka ek alag list ban gaya, distributor ka alag ban gaya. We can create different lists and shoot the messages to different category of people also.
Absolutely. So as a business owner, again, one of the very peculiar challenges that you face is when you are meeting someone, you came across some lead. You often lose contact with that, or you just note it somewhere. All those issues happen. So what we do in this case is that, again, we create a simple mechanism of capturing leads and assigning it to our staff. So Hitesh bhai will actually assign something for me and we'll see. But I'm just putting something, a new lead for, let us say, Manish, right? And I give, let's say, Vikas as the name, right? And I give some number. So what this will do is that it will create a lead within the system that you would have access for a later time to further follow up or send promotion messages to, as well as it will assign it to your user or your employee for further follow up. So this could be for a particular lead, or it could also be for a task where a task could be created. And then we say, okay, follow up with, let's say, again, Vikas for payment, right? So these tasks that they get created, and then once they get created, they can simply be followed up via the system. Again, the whole attempt around this is that whatever you are doing on a day-to-day basis, you should be able to digitize that and record it. And of course, once you record that, a lot of analytics and insights gets created, which helps you improve your business processes. Hitesh bhai, you want to assign some tasks to me?
Yeah, I just assigned you one task.
Okay. So this is a promotion message that I just now created, which has come across. So whoever that message comes across to them. So sending promotion messages becomes much, much easier for you once you do that. Kind of create broadcast lists or keep on creating groups and other things. Okay, now realizing the financial side of it and the challenges around that, a lot of businesses, traders, businesses are still very comfortable with Tally as the core accounting software, as well as for managing your inventory. So we've gone ahead and integrated with Tally to pull all the data across and made it all available right there on WhatsApp itself. So let me just give you a few examples of that. So let's say I am saying, I want to get, let's say, current account balance of Just Signs, one of the company, right? I just send that across. The system goes across, talks to the system, and gets you the details. Okay, and in fact, what we've done is that in order to ease that further process so that you don't have to type every time, what you can do is I'm actually sending a voice message via my phone. We'll see how that plays out. Okay, just one second. Account details for Sri Lakshmi Auto Services. So that's all that you want to send, and it will translate your message and get you the details. So what we've done here is that we've got the entire data set for the last fiscal year in this case. It could be year to date also, and provided all the various transactions that happened with this company. So that is as far as your accounting needs and then getting those insights is concerned. There are, of course, a lot of other things we are working on in generating daily reports, your ability to understand and get the quality of relationship with a customer, through a backend analytics that we'll do, and then give you. So let's say you're meeting with a customer, let's say Bhagwati Traders, right? And you want to know how that relationship is. What is the aging of the payment that the customer has? How has the business been going with them, so that you can talk in a more, you know, informed manner. So you just ask, okay, send me analysis for Bhagwati Traders. We automatically do that and then make it available for you. So that's one angle of it, which is the accounting part of it. There's also a very interesting angle, which is quite relevant for B2B businesses and distribution chain. So a lot of time, you might be getting calls from your distributor or your dealer, sab wo uska stock available hai kya? Kitna maal hoga uska available? Main order kar dun kya? So a lot of your energy goes into, you know, answering those queries. And if you ask these distributors or dealers or retailers to go ahead and log in into an application or download an app and do it, they would not possibly do it. So what we've done is that we can enable the distributor itself to get the details. So for example, we are saying inventory details for one of the products let's say yellow wax is one of the products that Hitesh Bhai has, right? It gets this. So it's not as if just this is enabled. So we do again an intent analysis, check stock for right or something, right? All these queries are enabled, and as the system improves, it would learn better and be able to answer most of those queries. It could be voice, or it could be text-based queries that are sent across. So a lot of your energy goes off or gets saved by doing this. Also, what it does is that, let's say, the customer inquired about a stock which is not available. Now, that's a lost business for you. But if the person had called you and you said, "Nahi sab, wo to maal nahi hai mere paas," right? How do you capture that information? Now, because it is digitized, you are automatically being able to capture that information and a report available to you, wherein you can say, okay, this is the trend for items which people ask for and are not available. And then that's where the exception management part comes into, that you're managing exceptions rather than a great insight that Shripal ji had when I had first met him about six, seven months back. He had shared that the focus has to be that a business owner should just be managing the exceptions rather than managing the transactions, so that they can focus on growth rather than just the operational day-to-day activities. Now, ultimately, all this is of use, besides the digitizing and saving your time, is once we kind of generate interesting insights about your business and make it available right across to you. So there is not absolutely very applicable to you, but you might find it interesting, and that is a business who does about roughly about 20 lakh 18 to 15 to 20 lakh rupees of business on our platform, and he is into supply of grocery items to gated societies. So this is a single page snapshot that we have created for this business. Prakriti Vegetable is the name, on how they are performing, right? So month to date sales, the total payments, total orders, how their business is performing. So as you can see, during the peak COVID second wave, there was a significant increase in his business because, you know, a lot of ordering moved online. Now, realizing this thing that there is a decreasing trend, which of course he would observe, but he clearly understands how that is going, right? He's added, you know, other items like dry fruits and sweets and biryani and other products to his list so that they can, you know, easily kind of fill the gap that they have on the sales side. A further analysis on what are their top customers, look at, you know, filtering because it's a very hyper-local based commerce, look at specific, you know, society, how that business is, what are the top customers there, what are the top products that are being sold at each society level, month on month, how the trend is. So that's just the starting part of it. The lost business because of the stock unavailability, all of this is intended to come in here so that you can easily analyze your business. And also through a push mechanism on your WhatsApp on a regular basis, on demand or on a schedule basis so that you know how your business is going. Hitesh bhai, I think now you want to take over?
Yeah. Thank you, Manish. Thanks for your demo. There are a lot of unanswered questions or a lot of queries which are there, which we'll probably take after this. Now, very interestingly, we wanted to, you know, see how Jito can leverage this community commerce. And so how can we leverage Jito network to promote community and social commerce? We have a lot of small, medium businesses, Jito JBN sellers. So we are giving a website and they can create product and catalog through this SnapPay model where we have multiple products available. And ye SnapPay ko platform ko use karke, we can also help businesses grow, not just do e-commerce, but a lot of marketing activities, CRM activities, say overall business growth ka we can target. Now there's one very interesting angle to this whole business model, and that's where community commerce comes into play. We have a huge pool of ladies wing and Jain ladies who want to do something, but they don't know what to do and how to do. They have a lot of time on hand. So what SnapPay is providing is these ladies or youth or homemakers can become affiliates to the Jito merchants. And inko ek khud ka website bhi milega, affiliates ko khud ke brand name se milega, and the affiliate can choose to sell. Let's say I am into car care business, so one of the affiliate can choose to sell my products. So all he or she has to do and go and select my product. And unke website mein wo mera product aa jayega. Whatever order comes, I will be servicing the order, and the affiliate gets their commission. Affiliates ko individual business panel bhi milega, backend dashboard milega, jisse they can track how much business they are doing, and you know what commission they are generating, etc. So this is a beautiful example of how we can create a community commerce around the whole Jito ecosystem. And this is about the whole product. Now, coming to question and answers, if you can start with question and answers. Somebody had raised hand.
Mera video nahi chal raha
na. Vinod ji, you can unmute yourself and ask your question. Vinod Kumar ji. Okay, I think he's not available. Any other questions do we have? You can raise hands. I can unmute them and we can take the questions.
I just wanted to give a overall view. Can I speak?
Yes, of course, my friend.
For all the members who are present here, the focus was what are the options of a particular offline store going online. So one of the options was a website or a microsite. Using a microsite, you can probably showcase your catalogs and showcase your products. That is one option. Option two was using a WhatsApp bot and making sure that all your products are being properly shown to the customer. And obviously, the third option is the website of Jito as like a Just Dial kind of concept, where all the products of yours are on that particular discovery platform. So these are the three options probably anybody can use to take their offline business immediately online and probably improve their sales. That is a focus. And using that as the background, I think Manish ji and Hitesh bhai are trying to show okay, this is one of the possibilities that could be used. SnapPay again is one of the platforms that could be used. Then there are other platforms also. But ultimately, if you want immediate usage of SnapPay, then Manish bhai is always there to handhold and make sure that all the backend benefits are being utilized properly. Just a simple another example could be mydukan.io is there, where I think similar populating that catalog could be done. So I think that is just, I'm giving you a brief overview of what we had in mind in taking this thing forward. And now I think Q&A session can get started and we can answer the questions.
Okay. So Manish, I have one very interesting question since Mahesh bhai asked, in fact, informed that there are multiple platforms. So there's one question from Samta saying, how can I migrate from DotPay to SnapPay?
Okay. Sure. Fair enough. Let me share my screen, Hitesh bhai.
So for the benefit of members, DotPay is also one more platform available where people can start selling online.
Right. So what I'll do is I'll actually very quickly walk you through the entire process of registering, as well as getting your website ready and then creating your catalog. So let us say I am calling it as Jito Demo for now, for the sake of demo. I could do it for Samta also, or she can actually go ahead and do that. But I'll just give an example of how that is done. So that was the display name. Then you provide, that was the official business name. Then you provide your business name here. Let's say I'm actually going to call it the same for the sake of demo and time, right? Provide your full name. And then let us say, again, I call it as Jito Demo at SnapPay.
Send this to 500 people.
I give my pin code and we are actually good to go. Right. I would call it, let's say, I'm in Gachibowli, Hyderabad. Of course, we'll need to give a full address. So the bot is basically capturing all the information. And let us say Samta is in, for example, bakery products, for example. And
Manish, I've already, Samta has personal messaged me the DotPay link, if you can.
Okay. Sure. Can you forward that to me?
I've sent it on WhatsApp.
You've sent it. Okay, great. So let us say she is also into dry foods, for example, right? So she can send those details across, and that's where the magic is happening. The system is creating a website for specifically for Samta, and meanwhile, let me just get the DotPay link. Okay. So it might take a little bit time. Hitesh bhai, you might want to take other questions while...
Yeah. So till then, we'll take some other questions. Yeah. Till the time you migrate Samta's .pay website. Any other...
Hitesh bhai, actually, it got created. For example, here, this is, of course, a blank website that got created. Now what we'll do is that because she already has a .pay site and we have an inbuilt mechanism and we are building more mechanisms to directly do the migration from one website to the other, one e-store to the other, just sending that. And what the system will do is that it will create a store from it and confirm back once that has been done. So it might take a few minutes. Meanwhile, Hitesh bhai, you might want to take some questions.
Okay, I think Piyush Lunia had one question. Piyush ji, please go ahead.
This is with reference to the marketing. When we are sending a list, promotional message to all the list, do they have to save our number in their phone or not? Does it work like a broadcast? No.
Hitesh bhai, you want to take that?
Yeah. So, Piyush, no, it doesn't work like a broadcast. It actually goes like an individual message. Having said that, the number, you have to be very cautious about sending the WhatsApp messages. You cannot be blasting, 200, 300, 500 messages in a day. WhatsApp might block the number. So, you have to be very cautious and very focused and dedicated marketing you can do. With your existing customers, I would suggest that. I mean, you're open to send it to anyone, any number, but then the risk of WhatsApp blocking the number is high if you're sending like 500 messages every day.
Got that. Thank you.
Right. So in fact, the web store is ready for Samta. And as you can see, she can now start taking orders on the site. So if you see, it was just 5-7 steps and less than a couple of minutes. And she has her web store ready, wherein she can actually just go ahead and forward that link with people and start taking orders.
Great. So, I mean, this is one very amazing feature. I mean, .pay, within 2 minutes, you've been able to move your website completely here. And then you can, of course, run all the other backend operations, what have been shown earlier. Vikas had created one shop. So I would like Vikas to please give your feedback. Manish, I think his website is created, I believe. He sent me a personal message.
Right.
Vikas, would you like to
share
your experience?
Yeah, the store has been created and the process was very seamless. Just wanted to understand in terms of how this will be listed on the WhatsApp, the store input, and what kind of confirmation I will be getting post creation, as I have already uploaded the products and the portfolio, everything.
Yeah, so Vikas, your web store is now ready and we will be sharing with you a document like this. You should be getting soon that. In fact, the bot itself will start sending that soon, wherein all the help videos are available through which you can just understand how to add items, how to track the inventory through the system, how to enable the B2B angle of that, right? So all those things are made available through specific 2-minute, 3-minute videos, which you can use for, understanding and using the system. We are, of course, available anytime for any support need. Now, the other thing, Vikas, is that your site, because you're a Jito member, would automatically get registered once we assign it to the Jito chapter as part of the jitobangalore.com. And you'll be able to you know, use it for, you know, propagating the message across to people. So, that's how the messaging will go across. And the JBN Jito number automatically gets assigned. All the messaging will happen via that route. In fact, just to kind of give you a perspective of the, you know, management features, I had earlier shown the dashboard. There is specifically for B2B businesses, a very interesting feature we've built, wherein you can very quickly create your catalog or price list, if you call it. So I'll show it via Hitesh Bhai's company and see how that plays out. Very briefly, Hitesh Bhai, if you allow, I won't get into, you know, too much details. But what Hitesh Bhai has done is that he's created these various customer groups wherein all the different members and the items with specific discount have been attached to them. And it has been assigned to specific, you know, individuals or roles. So you could assign it to individual people or to specific roles. And based on that, they would see the price list or not see the price list. So because he's made it as a public price list, if I just go and, you know, look at this, I will be first asked to log in. And only if I'm permitted to see the price list, I can go ahead and place an order. So a lot of such B2B specific features we've built, a lot of promotion activities can be done, wherein you can create, you know, specific seasonal promotions and customer referrals and other things to enable you to push your B2C and B2B sales.
Yeah, that's one of the very good features we have, Manish. I think different prices. In fact, prices, जो भी नंबर हम असाइन करते हैं वो नंबर से ही प्राइस दिखेगा. दूसरा कोई नंबर से लॉगिन करेगा तो प्राइस नहीं दिखेगा उनको. सो इट्स अ वेरी हेल्पफुल फीचर फॉर B2B, स्पेशली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स हो या रिटेलर्स हो. वी हैव कपल ऑफ रेज्ड हैंड्स. प्रवीण जी कोठारी हैज वन क्वेश्चन. प्रवीण जी प्लीज गो अहेड.
हेलो, दिस इज प्रवीण कोठारी. आई हैव कपल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बल्क फीचर अवेलेबल फॉर दिस? Like, can I put it in an Excel and upload?
Absolutely. So we will be conducting specific workshops for Jito Bangalore, where we'll actually do a hands-on catalog creation, supply plan definition, the marketing activities and other things to, you know, assist you in doing that. But there is a straightaway mechanism wherein you can directly download a template and fill that up and upload that. In fact, that is available for not just your items, for your customers also. You can simply go ahead and import your customers rather than doing that. In fact, in case you are deciding to, you know, integrate with Tally for your system, the entire customer database and the inventory items gets pulled directly from Tally itself and get created there.
Okay, my second question is, along with images, can videos also be recognized by customers? Like, are videos allowed?
Yeah, so typically what we've seen is that people are using mobile for their ordering, for their e-commerce need. Now, we try and make the website or the ordering site as light as possible. Okay. I don't see a problem in enabling showing videos also of the products, though as of now, we have not enabled it.
Or maybe YouTube links of videos?
Yeah, absolutely. So at the item level, you can go ahead and, so let me show it here, right? Define various, description and other things, where links and other stuff can be provided. So one of the businesses, we in fact migrated them from .pay again. They've given a lot of details about their products right across here. And this thing also can be provided. The YouTube link and other things can also be provided there.
Okay. And do we have control over the keywords? Like, can I have my own set of keywords for the WhatsApp communication?
Keywords in terms of the specific, keywords to which the system responds?
Yeah, that is the system specific. Can I create my own specific keywords?
Right. So we have a do-it-yourself system available. So the entire chat flow, I believe you know about it, is a structured hierarchical system through which the messaging happens. So we have a comprehensive do-it-yourself mechanism through which you can customize your flows as well.
Okay. Does it involve any language or is it user-friendly?
I'll actually show it to you. Just to give you a perspective, this is something which right now our team uses, but we can make that available for you as well, right? So the entire flow, in fact, the JBN bot has been built using this system, wherein the entire flow can be kind of customized specifically to a business as well.
Okay, my last question is, for how does the system recognize if someone who is messaging is a B2B or a B2C customer? Like, is there any mechanism where that can be possible?
Yeah. So a B2B customer, for example, let's say I'll again take an example of Hitesh Bhai, right? He has both B2B and B2C customer, right? So let me actually go ahead and try and do that. I go here and I say login, and I don't know if this is already there. Probably this number would already be there, but essentially we ask the customer whether they are end customer or they would like to register themselves as a dealer or a retailer. Okay, once they register themselves, in case you decide that specific role needs an approval, the role would directly get assigned or a request sent to you on WhatsApp itself to approve that particular registration. And once you approve it, they start getting recognized as a B2B customer. Once they've been recognized, when they send a hi, then automatically, based on their WhatsApp number, we know that it's a B2B customer. It starts progressing on that basis.
Okay. And my final question, I'm taking a lot of time.
No, please go ahead.
Can all this data be integrated to an Excel sheet? Can be exported, I mean?
Absolutely. Again, like the import case, we have all the pieces where, you can download the details, right? The summary, this thing, your catalog also, you can go ahead and export all your transactions, you can export. So all the necessary data sets that we have are actually exportable.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks right. a lot.
And just to give you again a very quick perspective around that is, let's see if my number, basically the system kind of gets used in different roles. Sometimes it gets confused, right? We can go ahead and then create, delivery list. A very relevant piece which some of our merchants love, where what needs to go tomorrow, we give a beautiful list of items that needs to be sent across that you can then give to your packers or any of your staff for processing. Similarly, for example, let's take a look at the various shortcuts available. Right, you can send promotion messages. We've talked about lead and task management. You can ask for a delivery list. I'll actually go ahead and show a right. So let's say there is a merchant whose details we are trying to get. So we try and check for tomorrow's delivery. I want the delivery list, or I want dispatch sheets to be created. All of those, we try and make it right available as Excel sheet or PDF on WhatsApp itself.
Okay, my last question. Since you told you can integrate it to ShipRocket, ShipRocket has a chain of delivery partners. Now, can I select which delivery partner I want for every order, or can it be auto-selected?
Yeah, it is. Typically, we use something called, which I believe you would be aware, something called Smart Ship Rocket or something they call it, wherein they try and determine the best possible rate and the dispatch details combination. So as a customer, I'll actually show one of our businesses that is a sample business that we have. Let's just quickly go ahead and place an order. It won't take more than 30 seconds. Okay, so I'm selecting this as the location now. This is actually coming from ShipRocket. Okay, now our system, when it talks to ShipRocket, it tries to determine based on the delivery date and the charges whether to show one or multiple options. So if they had an express delivery available, which was giving us a better date, we would have given the customer to choose from and place an order again. In this case, this was the best option, so we just went ahead. So in fact, ShipRocket would have given multiple options. We've just selected this one and an order placed, and the amount was coming there itself from there. This is, by the way, we have our own payment gateway for UPI. So that's where you got redirected to, wherein we send a payment link right there on WhatsApp itself. That's a very important angle to it, because a lot of time the payment fails when done offline, online. So in order to enable offline payment also, we simply send a payment link which gets triggered and can be used by GPay or PhonePe or Paytm, any UPI applications. To do that, and in this case, I've selected pay on delivery. The order gets confirmed here. And as a business, you get your order details, and whenever you are comfortable, you can go ahead and say, okay, I'm ready to ship. This will go ahead and create an order with ShipRocket for a pick and other details. Of course, a tracking details created for that.
Okay. And can we integrate even Shopify websites and other kind of websites directly, which are existing already?
Yes. We've done certain integrations already for certain businesses. In specific cases, we can discuss. So a lot of our customers, Praveen, prefer a Shopify. We are not competing with Shopify from a B2C angle for their B2C business, but for B2B, they use our product. So the backend integration between Shopify and us, it enables the a seamless catalog management, order management, and now.
Okay. So one very important point which probably we missed. So the whole setup, everything is free. We've negotiated with SnapPay on this. The only charges will be the transactional charges. Jo order aata hai agar, B2C के लिए the charges are 2% and B2B के लिए 20 rupees per order is the only charge you have to pay. Of course, there are some additional add-on charges, जैसे promotional messages अगर भेजना WhatsApp पे, there are some charges which can be discussed with Manish offline. That's about the thing.
Sorry, but one last question. This promotional messages go via WhatsApp, right?
Yes.
Because I've faced this problem where I've got blocked, where I've sent 200-250 messages.
Yeah, like Hitesh Bhai was saying, right? So there are a number of tools available for sending bulk messages via WhatsApp. The problem is that the success rate for them is pretty bad. But when it comes from a known number, it is often a better way to deal with, right? Especially for your distribution chain, for your known existing customers. So bulk messaging for known customers is something which we've tried to enable via this system. Other bulk messaging platforms are plenty of them, but sending from a known number in an easy and simple manner, this is what we are trying to achieve here.
Thanks a lot, Manishji and Hiteshji.
Thank you. So Vikas has one more question. How can a non-JITO member access their store on WhatsApp? So Manish, you want to take that question?
Sure, Vikas. So like we have a common number that is this JITO JBN number, which in a way is a marketplace for specifically for JITO Bangalore members. Similarly, we have a common number available for everyone else who wants to participate in that. So based on the location of the person, the list of merchants comes across. I'm not sure if it will, again, my number might be registered against different people, but so here, because I'm registered for a certain location, which is Astha Green Homes, if there are any other suppliers that are supplying there, they get listed and I can choose and select from them and then place an order. So depending on which location you are, the number would remain the same, but for the customers in that geographical location would see you or not see you based on whether you are wanting to supply there or not. And you control that through your supply plan, wherein you choose what all are the societies, geographical areas, or specific pin codes that you are intending to supply to. And also a very interesting aspect around hyperlocal is that we enable you to aggregate your deliveries. So a lot of time when supplying to societies or gated communities and all, you might not want to send one person for each order because it's very expensive. So what you do is that you say, okay, I am supplying daily next day. All the orders, let's say from a society I get, I club them all together, 50 orders. I send one person who delivers together. Very optimal in terms of a hyperlocal kind of a scenario.
Any number, how to be part of the SnapPay community?
That's it. You are registered in SnapPay. So automatically you get, listed out there as a merchant in the SnapPay community.
Noted.
So I think I've given my number, Manish's number and the support number of SnapPay on the chat messages. Vinod Kumar has one question. So we'll take one last question from Vinodji. Vinod, go ahead, please. Vinodji, are you there? Okay.
Hitesh Bhai, can you also share in the chat the registration link?
Yes, I've shared the link. You can again put that slug.
I'm just not sharing it. Right.
So we have one more last question which we can take before we go to the next session. Anyone has any question? Okay, so Manish, you can share your number, the register option on the chat here.
Right.
And let's move to the next session of giving vote of thanks. So I will invite Vijayji Behta, who is a co-convener of JBN Bangalore, to please come in.
Good evening, one and all. I would like to give special thanks to our chief speaker, Manishji Agrawal of SnapPay, who has given a deep insight on how to upscale our business. His valuable inputs will surely help all the members present here to grow their business multifold. Would like to also acknowledge the immense support of beloved Chairman Ashokji Nagori, Secretary Maheshji Nahar, and JBN Convener Hiteshji Palrecha, and of course Jito Apex and MC members. This event wouldn't have been possible without the presence of all our participants who have taken out their time for this event. Thank you all, and we would surely come up with a more such session in the coming months. Signing off, this is Vijay Mehta, JBN co-convener, Bangalore chapter. Thank you.
Thank you. So we have one last thing I wanted to just add. We will be running a lot of sessions, handholding sessions. The message will be passed on all the JITO groups. Maybe coming this week, we'll have one handholding session in the JITO office where you can bring your laptop and you can actually register if you have any issues, facing any issues, we can do that also. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Manish.
Thank you, Manishji. Thank you, everyone.
Have a good evening. Bye.
Bye.